about that one. Pescara defeat 3-2. It's the only blot in quite a while, actually. Been in good form since December. Bad form. We've only lost twice since November after a wretched October. Really did put us on the back foot in the league. I got off, then decided to play the Perugia game. We were 1-0. And we have made a signing, guys. And I've also lined another one up, but I'm pretty skint right now. We have 26k on the wage. On the transfer budget, sorry, and the wage is about 4. Just on a pre-contract signing, we're looking at a guy to sign. Obviously, I can't use all my money because I need to keep money to potentially sign players and also to send our scout out again at the end of the season to Italy. We can't afford even missing a couple of months where a scout could be out finding players. We did also have a scout player come through, actually. I'll show you first and foremost. I think it's this keeper, and he wasn't that good. We did sign a guy up. I think he's like 58 rating or something. Mancini just needs to turn 16 already, man. This guy would be a starter, an absolute beast. But we did make a sign of guys, and it's Pietro Pellegrini. Oh, probably need to bring into the first team now. Who is dropping out? It changes our formation when we go attacking, of course. It's Palombi. So Pellegrini, we signed up. I'll show you in a second. We offered 500 grand plus Fiamozzi, I think. Fiamozzi was 70 rated right winger. Good player, our only player really who could play right wing, naturally. But you know, we were just going to wait until Mancini gets promoted. We had to get him in, guys, because Pettinari, of course, in the last stream got injured. He's out for 8 weeks. That's a massive injury. Our top scorer. The season, I wouldn't actually call it a struggle. I checked myself at the end of last time. I'm used to success in this game. I don't sound like a dickhead, but I am. On career mode, I've never had anything but success and achieved a goal. But looking at this, we're actually 5 points behind Crotone. Apologies, forgot. Crotone did lose their last game. Looking at this, it's looking like automatic promotion could be tough. We're 10 points behind Benevento, they have a game in hand. I've kind of given up on them, they're unbeaten already. We only have 16 games left in the league. It's going to be 9 impossible to catch them. We'd have to pretty much get at least 44 points, I'd say, from our last games and hope that they fuck up. Crotone are catchable though, they are our next opponent in the league. We are 4 points behind Pescara as well, 1 ahead of Palermo, 2 ahead of Padova, 3 ahead of Perugia, 7 clear of Ascoli and Hellas Verona. Still, 7. We've only really smashed a couple of teams, and funnily enough, they were the two teams either side of us in the league. Palermo, we beat 4-1, we beat Pescara 3-0. We drew a Crotone earlier on the season, and with just a 3-day gap, you know, we have had our winter break. It came at a good time, guys, really. Because it did waste a couple of weeks where Pettinari was injured. So, in fact, we've probably got 5 or 6 weeks left now. But yeah, Fiorentina is second. Crotone and Palermo are both around us. You know, we need to win both of these games, really, I think, if we're going to be up and around there for automatic promotion. I'll still try my best to beat these. Anything as a bonus. The good thing is, for the first time all season, really, I'm putting the pressure off myself. Will be Pellegrini's debut. I didn't actually show you this sale. The transfer, sorry guys, I will start a game very soon. It's the last thing I have to show you, I promise. It's transfer history, isn't it? It's the only signing we've made so far. I suppose I should show you the other player that I'm considering getting. He'd be a right signing. My club, so yeah, it was 544 grand plus Fiamozzi. Actually took a wage cut as well. Pellegrini, I think he was on something like 5 grand at Monaco or so, I don't know, and he took a wage cut. I think I got him on a 1900 euro deal. We also did sell Arrigoni and Tabanelli. We saw that at the end of last stream. I think we accepted them offers and they moved once the window started. So it's basically this Arrigoni, Tabanelli, whose contracts are out at the end of the season anyway, and Fiamozzi for Pellegrini, which I'll take all day, to be fair. Fiamozzi will be a big miss. I didn't really want to lose more players. We have quite a small squad right now, but we do have a number of youth players just waiting to turn 16. There we are. We have a 21-man squad. I'm going to have to shuffle things, guys. I'm just going to put Lofaso on the wing, I think. Might need to bring another player in to to be fair. I'll check how they line up from the base screen there. But yeah, the one other thing to show then, guys, is this player I really want. He would be a right signing, if we can find him. Yeah, this guy we had gone in from, Filippo Costa. Look at this guy, boys. Left mid slash left wing back. I probably end up just playing him left wing, because he is quite quick. 80 acceleration, 69 sprint speed. His strength isn't great, so yeah, he probably is best on the wing. Stamina 69. But look at him technically. His ball control, his crossing, his dribbling, his short passing, all decent. He's only 23, so we can't actually pre-sign him. 71 rated already, would be one of our best players. High work rate, that really allures me. The only problem is, we're about a grand off his wage, if we spend everything on a sign-on bonus, so we do need money. I need to sell someone else. I don't even think you actually get money off the cup in Italy, if I recall. So I've done a save in Italy in the past, so... just looking at players I've transfer listed. There aren't even many available to transfer list, guys. Might loan us Ricci. No, we should probably train him, actually. We have Mechie Aurelio on loan, but, you know, I don't really want to get rid of him. Bovo we can't even sell right now. I'd say there's only one or two candidates, I think. I'll show you them in a minute. Pietro Pellegri, by the way, guys, we got in, showing great potential. It said he was actually an exciting prospect online. So I don't know if it's an update in something or that'll go up as well. It was the same with Sandro Tonali. When I started a career in like September, October, early on in the game before like the latest update for career mode, Tonali was an exciting prospect, and now he's, in fact, he has potential to be special. Now he is only an exciting prospect. And the same with Pellegrini, he's gone down. He's supposed to go to an 88. Now I'd say the max he'll get to is an 84. So I don't know what to make of that. Maybe it will adjust one day. But he's still a good signing. At just 17 years old, 68 rated. Here he is. High, medium, three star. He's injury prone, apparently, which is a bit of a concern, because that's the reason we brought him in, basically. But he has the best finishing in the whole squad, guys. Betting Petinari and Palombi is finishing 73. His heading accuracy is a bit shit. We could train that, I suppose. He's kind of quick as well, 65-74. He's got 74 strength as well, which I like. Stamina's only 6 in 5 weeks. Yeah, we have, of course, wasted a couple of weeks off camp. Palombi's only on loan as well. I was looking at selling to Minari. Have we really sold him? We must have. Or, I don't know, he was on loan. I think I cancelled his loan to try and afford cost faster, that 23-year-old guy, whatever his name was, and we couldn't actually afford him. I've loan listed Francesco Santoro. Might free up a bit of money. The key one is that we need to get rid of Major. We can't even, it won't even let us sell him. So, yeah, I mean, it's a struggle right now, guys. I'm not even sure I can sell anyone. Can I sell Lofaso? Am I have to sell Petinari? It won't let me. Well, Scavone's on loan as well. Patricioni might be the one, guys. Again, I can't even sell him, for fuck's sake. What about Calderoni? No. Can't sell Riccardi. Can't sell Bovo. Or Lucioni. It's just ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. Don't want to sell Ricci. And we can't sell any of us. It's tough going, guys. I mean, I need to get money to afford that guy, really. It would be too good a deal to pass up. Yeah, just 1 second. I need to turn this alarm off. Yeah, it would be way too good a deal to pass up. And sadly, it looks like we're not quite going to have enough. And I cannot think of another way to get money right now. We do, as I say, need to save a bit. I had him to the point where he accepted 5,400, but then with the sign-on bonuses and stuff, it was a shame. I was basically, like I said, about a grand or on the wage, about 20 grand on sign-on bonus away from being able to afford him. It is frustrating we don't get money for this as well, this game. I'm just going to line up like that, guys, and see how it sorts itself out once we start. and we'll have to adjust. So, sorry, this is the longest, by far the longest it's been before we've actually gotten to a game, aside from the first episode where we're doing all the transfers, of course. I will hop straight into Fiorentina now. Oh my god, actually, I'm a moron. I did say this whole time I'm going to rest for Crotone, and I've just completely forgot to do it. Fuck. Alright, so be it, guys. I mean, we do have a week after Crotone. We'll just have to manage the Crotone game a bit better. We're just going to go for this cup game, then. Fuck it. We'll still get smashed, I assume. Fiorentina are one of the strongest sides in the competition, of course.
Fiorentina's lineup for you. 4-3-3, and they've got natural wide.
I mean, miracles can happen. You never know. With young boys, I've beaten better teams than Fiorentina. I beat Arsenal once with young boys. It's Cavone. Looks like he's been pushed to the right wing. Ball in. It's a header! Oh my god, boys! We take the lead! Is that Pellegri on debut? It might be Palombi. Get him, boys! That was nothing! Unexpected lead. Come on! What to do now, though? Do we just sit back? This would be massive. It is a one-leg game. Number 10, who are you? It's Simone Lefaso, the signing we made. We've bemoaned at times this season as being an absolute shit part of the side. We did drop him along with Falco earlier on, and to be fair, I was saying back in the last stream, guys, even though the last game we played, we lost. Since we went for fuck's sake, it didn't last long. Simeone equalises. For fuck's sake. Yeah, since we brought Lofaso and Falco back in the side, we were kind of forced into it, really, by the formation change. They have actually both been decent. So what, we might be in again here. What a game this is. Jello Cross. Get on that. End to end, lads. We're giving Fiorentina a fright here. But it was really frustrating that we held that lead for like 2 minutes. I don't even think we touched the ball again. The next time we touched the ball was to kick off.
He's got support here.
Oh, well done, boys.
A chance to break away now on the counter.
Get on that.
Cleared away by the defender.
Come on, lads. We can do this. I believe now. Scavone. Tonali. Riccardi.
Oh.
Well in Pellegri. On debut. Doing bit. It's Falco. Good ball.
Ooh, time to get
look for another
there.
Cross. It's deflected. And we get there. The it was Lefaso again. You, Alan, he is a threat in the air, guys. Come on. He's 6 foot two. Well, you've got to be committed. He'll be our best player in the air now that Petinari's injured. Hello, I suppose Lucio needed to maybe argue that as well.
Piazza.
Piaka.
Still got a bit to do, but this is promising.
It's dreadful from the lad. I don't know what to do. If I fall behind 2-1, I think I will actually like take players off early and just look more towards a Crotone game. But if we're still in it, I've got to go for it. Imagine we won the cup in the Europa League. That'd be fucking insane.
The opposition saw the pass coming.
It's never going to happen. We've played to Juventus and Napoli in here, but I mean, we are hanging with Fiorentina at the moment. Well done, Lofaso. It's unlucky we still didn't get the ball there.
He's picked his pocket there, and he's away with the ball.
Well played, Macchiarelli. I know. I've played myself into trouble, though. Come on, lads. Get the tackle. Go on that. Come on, Vigorito, man. You had so long to get to that. I'll be furious if they score from this. First corner of the game for Fiorentina. Alright, it's straight to Vigor.
Sloppy work, really.
Come on, lads.
Piazza.
It's the kind of shit we can't afford to do, giving them the ball like that.
The shot's on! No real trouble for the goalkeeper.
Well done, Tonali.
They've
Falco.
Lost the ball, and the counter-attack could be there.
Pellegri. Falco. He's pacing this attack. Go on, Pellegri. Use that strong flop.
The goal has gone with that clearance.
Well done, boys.
Really getting at the opposition Falco. This far up the pitch now.
Oh, looking for Lofaso. They read it well. The defender. It's Benassi. Now, gives it Milenkovic. No, oh, that's fucking hell. It stayed in. I gave up on that. Like a tit head. Well done, Lucioni. Fuck this, let's just clear it.
It's out of danger there with that clearance.
I ain't passing out anymore. I'm done with that shit. Oh, well done, Riccardi. Good interception, and now it's Falco. Come on, Pellegri. Make the run. You find him. Come on.
He has cleared it well.
Cleared in the end. It's Calderoni. Flick that on. Yes, lad. Can hit it. Tonali, can hit them. Oh, good save, Terracciano. Oh, you lucky bastards. I'm taking chances then. Fiorentina, and again, you jammy bastard. Unlucky. Falco did really well to close him down, get the interception, but obviously it falls perfectly for them. There is Falco. Going to give that one to Lofaso to chase.
In
fact, it's Pellegri.
Gets his cross in.
Header. Oh, put wide. Lofaso keeps winning it. In fact, it's Scavone. Beg your pardon, lad. Still need to memorise these players. Milenkovic. And they turn. Give to Cesciarini. Vote. I've not been impressed by Fiorentina in this game at all. Half time in Florence, guys. 1-1. I will definitely take that as something to build on potentially for that second half. The last thing we want is extra time. I don't think it goes to replay in here, so I probably will just go for it, go all out attack if it's still 1-0 for like 20 minutes left. I think I'm going to make a couple of subs as well, guys, to be fair, because so be it. Major's on the bench. He's been brought in because we lost Fiamozzi, so I can't bring him on actually, but I need to take him off the bench. He is an Italian, and of course, we can only use Italian players. Lofaso had a good game then, but we'll take him off for Palombi. The final change, I think I'll bring the Marino on for Tonali. We'll put Scavone back in midfield, put Marino there, Palombi there, and swap Marino with Calderoni. We play Calderoni in left wing at times, and he's done well.
Interesting football from Italy in the context of this Coppa Nazionale, the Italian domestic cup. Second half to come, and a quarter-final place at stake.
First, oh, good touch. Hit that. Oh, good block.
Piazza.
We've got this guy. We're playing well. Come on. For a first game in the stream. Usually a bit rusty. First game. We're doing well here.
Well read.
Might be in again. Hit that. Oh, lucky lads.
Will be a corner.
That's Sandro Tonali, I think. He hits the deck.
Sensing a chance here. They've got to capitalise on these kind of set pieces.
We can do this. Win that. Oh, we're winning all sorts of headers against these mugs.
But
it's straight to Terracciano.
Oh, nothing wrong with that, was there? I thought he was going to score with a header, but top keeping.
Don't think I look at the match facts at half-time, guys. Apologies, I'll look right now, just very quickly. Yeah, we've been a better team. Come on, Lecce. Good interception, Venuti. Well done, lad.
There's a statement just what we need. From Stamford Bridge.
Could be a confidence boost that we can get promoted from Serie B. We're all playing a side that are probably like lurking around the European or mid-table spots in Serie A. They usually are in real life of late.
There's a substitute getting ready for Fiorentina.
Great play, boys. Come on.
It'll
be a corner. We have caused problems from corners. Look for another outswinger. Actually, I'm feeling the inswinger this time. Falco will take.
Corner played in. Good defensive clearance there. And now he's
Scavone.
For some support. Well, this is
I thought
corner,
I brought him off. Well, sub's not been made. I know, dropped him back to midfield, of course. I think it took Tonali. Need him rested.
And in it goes. The crowd of players, the keeper goes for a punch.
Oh, lucky lads. He's crowded out a bit then.
Jordan Veretout. Substitution now to be made by Fiorentina.
No. Trying to find an opening. No, boys. Oh, what a goal. Oh, they've had like two chances to score twice. What can you even do? This difficulty is like that sometimes. They passed it around well, couldn't really get close and down in time and tackle them. But what a finish that is, man.
Well, you're too.
The first time strike. And Fiorentina do take the lead.
A lot more came out than went in
I don't know why it's doing this.
For the attackers, that's a bonus of the change in the technology.
It was a really weird camera angle, but oh, man,
yeah,
what a goal.
He deserved that, though, because,
Fuenza leader puts him in front. I'm going to have to go ultra attack, guys. Let's just go for it. Heartbreak 2-1. In Florence. We're up in a better team, I think. However, we do trail. We have been unlucky this season a lot in terms of like performances, not getting the results that they deserve, and this might be a case again. I'm going to hit this. Yeah, another corner. Come on, lads. We have responded well, continuing the pressure on the Fiorentina goal. Let's go for the outswinger once more. Oh, it was dangerous. Hit that. No, why is it never deflect nicely for me? It's always for them. And when it's vice versa, it just falls on a plate for their players.
Poor attempt at a pass, really.
I was about to say it myself. That was shit. Falco.
20 minutes of the 90 still to play.
Come on, lads. Chiesa.
Now he's looking for support. Well, the cross has gone in, but there's no one there to get on the end of it.
Trescioni's just going to hold this. There's the ball.
It through.
Timed it well. Falco. Another great deal of pace.
Change of direction. Infield.
Well done, Falco. Chance. Get on there. No, why didn't let me let the player up top, man? I was trying. He could have just ran on that and side-footed it into the far corner. For fuck's sake. Fuck's sake. Just huffing and puffing, can't quite break them down. Story of my season, really, guys.
Well, they talk about football being a passing game.
You know, we look comfortable 99% of the time, but then they have one attack with it, and it's gods, just like that. What a ball that was. And I do not believe the scoreline. It does sum the season up. Look at this. I'm not even going to wait till the end of the game. We've dominated this match. 10 shots to their 6, 6 on target to their 4. They were 4 on target and scored 3. I'll keep must have made 2 saves according to this, because their goal went in off the post, of course. I don't even call them 2 saves. Isn't that some bullshit? It's not just us, the amount of crosses in, we've got close. And we haven't managed to get a shot out, but we've been really, really close to getting there.
Jordan Veretu.
They're just going to counter me now. Well, I'm on all out attack.
Piazza just moving the opposition around, maybe trying to wear them out by getting them to chase. Can whip it in
good
now.
Touch.
And here's the shot. Tried to find the winning ticket in the raffle, but a couple of numbers short.
I don't know whether I should have done something different, guys. Maybe should have just gone like defensive, ultra defensive, the second I scored. I don't know.
Jordan Veretout.
Doesn't always make a difference, because they will still have that. A couple of attacks a game, a couple of phases where they just play like gods. Like that, that was a insane turn. Oh, Muriel's just done me. Oh, and he scores a wonderful goal. They've scored some good goals, Fiorentina. 4-1 is so flattering to them, guys. It really is. I mean, I can't ignore the last 10 minutes, so I'd change my mind now and say it's kind of been an even game. Maybe we just edged it rather than dominated it. At the end of the day, they'd score 3 more than us. But it's just really, really unfortunate for us. We played well in this game, really did. We'll take some positives for the Crotone match from that. But at the end of the day, history just remembers the scoreline, guys, and it was a twatting in the end, 4-1. We had 10 shots to their 8, 6 on target to their 5. They edged possession, they had the better of the pass actually. We had 4 corners, they had 1. On the match for us goes to Scavone, gets an 8.7. Lofaso got an 8.1. Gavoni ended the game at centre back, apparently. The fuck. Who got man of the match for the match? And it was Piatta, got us 9.2. Then a number of players got good ratings. Chiesa, Benassi, Norgard, Muriel, Vertu, Fuenzalida, Simeone, and Ceccherini all played over an 8. Unlucky though, guys. We did ourselves proud in terms of performance then. For sure, we'll have games where we get dominated more and fare better in terms of the scoreline. I do think this is bullshit as well, I've noticed at the back end of last stream. Every Serie A team is drawn at home. Like, why? What the fuck? They shouldn't need protection. They all won except Inter. And Inter playing into another Serie A team anyway, to be fair, in Cagliari. But that is a big shock. Inter Milan out. Juventus beat Torino in a derby 3-1. Lazio knocked Benevento out. So they're also back in league action. That's a shame. We wanted Benevento to be occupied. Atalanta won on pens. Perugia, the only other team that were in Serie B left in it, also got knocked off 3-0 by Napoli. Roma and Milan also progressed. So it's kind of an expected final eight, really, with the exception of Inter Milan. Sorry guys, I was trying and failing to light a cigarette then. I need to use two lighters, it took a while. Who the fuck's this guy in Bakaogu? He's just leapt up in the top scorer list recently. I haven't looked at it in a while. Armenteros was neck and neck with Petinari, they've both been caught up. Petinari, of course, binged though. So, to be fair, if you're going to turn around and say to me, we'll win one, lose one of the next two. This would be the one I'd pick to win. So hopefully we do it. Melbourne City, you want to take Santoro's wage is only 500. But we don't really need him right now. They did want to train him to 60 and see what he's about. But it's just taking ages, guys. I've been training for 3 months. He's gone up like one rating. So fuck him. Hopefully we get him back next year and he's 60 rated anyway. I mean, I must say, I've kind of been disappointed with the youth return so far. We have got a couple of players through who I think are exciting prospects, to be fair. In fact, one might have been exciting prospect, one might have been showing great potential. But even like the academy coming up, some of them look like they could be okay. They're either low overalls though, or they're just not 16. Yeah, this guy looks decent, Michele Mancini. Luca Mancini is going to be insane, we know that. Just waiting on revisions of some of these. Yeah, Costa and Rizzo could be really good. Although we do have a left back. Michele Mancini as well is going to be really good. We have two of them. And they're both looking decent. How many Mancinis are there? We have three. So, big, big game this, lads. We played okay last time round. Oh my god, we are so fatigued. This is worse than I thought it'd be. We don't even have the players to come in for this shit. Colombia left, come on. Giuccione for Scavone. Thankfully, Tonali's fully fit. He is the most important player. Major needs to come off the bench. Santoro for now will get on the bench. I suppose Falco should be on over Scavone, I think. Where can Riccardi also play? Left back. Probably got Marino there. That'll have to do for now, I think, guys. No one else is that good. We don't have a great team right now. Great squad. Really is grim. But, as I said, last stream I actually played a lot better. I was starting to get used to 4-3-3 attack. The results kind of followed. They weren't insane. We were kind of going at the pace that we should be at, I think, 4 seconds. But yeah, we kind of matched Crotone's results last stream. However, we need to start bettering them. Starting by today. I've never ever seen this training session. I'm having me smoke. So I don't even think I'm going to do it. I've never once seen this. Is this new? I'm playing this one-handed, guys, because I have me smoke. Well, kind of like one hand, one finger. Yeah, we fucking failed that. We need better players before we can take these on. And guys.
Hi there, everybody. Alan Smith alongside me, Martin Tyler.
So, last pre-match drag of me, Sig. Let's do this, guys. If we get a Jesus player, I'm keen on this one. We drew with them in Lecce 2-2 earlier on the season, but we were the better team. Well, we put it up. And what it doesn't always matter though, it would be Pescara 5-0. To be fair, we outplayed Pescara last league game that we lost as well, and someone lost 3-2. Kind of summed it up. In here? Oh, for fuck's sake. Of course, the block falls perfectly for them. You know, if I did that, it would have fell for their other attacker in the box. It's Simi who caused us problems last game, boys. He has the strength, I mean. What the fuck that was. Michy is hell right now. She doesn't bode well.
We've got an excellent defensive side with the best defensive stats in the league against the side that scores the most goals. It's an intriguing prospect.
Walking into the ground, here, lads. Make up my mind how this match is going to play out. Oh, lucky lads.
Two teams, the best defence against the high scoring visitors. Fascinated.
Good ball. Tonali. Patricioni. Oh my God, that's what we're working with, lads. That's how shit my players are. I went for the finesse strike. That was just pathetic from Patricioni. See how the team does change with here. So we have Lofaso there. You can play there. Patricioni's right wing at the moment. Palombi should go there. Yeah, Jono should swap places. He's right footed. No, he has the better weak foot. Okay, yeah, we're fine there. Just one adjustment. Can't help but wonder if Palombo would have scored that now. The chance Patricioni had on the right wing. Lecce have no sub strikers. Here's at the moment. I'm using all of them. Of the I suppose Falco can play there. And he's stopped the 18 today. In goes the corner. Get rid of it, lads. Oh my just God. Big chance for Crotone and Mraz with the header. Just wide of the... Well, wide and over of the bar.
Got to keep the ball here under some pressure.
Tonali's going to spread this. Good ball. Just going to use the width of the pitch, lads. We're not particularly fast side, but
careless there.
It's the way to break them down. Go narrow. They just, they're too hard to get past on Legendary with players that don't have insane dribbling. We don't really have that right now either. Oh, God damn it.
Well and intercepted.
Good challenge, Patricioni. Well done, lad. Might be in here, lads. Tricardi. Gonna hold it. No, what the? How shit are you guys? A pass to the guy in the bottom of the screen. I held that in enough, the through ball. I'm pretty sure. But no, he decides to go for the nearest player. For fuck's sake. It is the worst team I've played with, and I've played with young boys. That sounded wrong. Young boys of Ben were one of our career mode series where we played with just Academy graduates, and I swear down, they just played better than this team. For me, Lecce, I just still not quite feeling them. Oh my God. Corrado puts the header over. I'm struggling with balls in right now, particularly corners, so I'm going to be wary about giving any more away. It's nice from you, Riccardi. He is one of our best prospects. Plays it on to Patricione.
He's coming forward.
Pellegrini. It's a dreadful ball. It's a simple pass, Pellegrini.
This is going to be a throw.
Well done, Patricione. An alright game there, actually. Tonali. Palombi. Good play. Look to drag it back. Tonali! Oh, follow that in.
Saved it.
Yes, lad, get in. It's like Faso again. He is stepping up, guys. Like Faso, for third goal in four games, I think, for the lad. It was absolute bits. It's actually fourth. I never did say, guys. Is it? I can't remember who got the winner against Padova now in the game we played off camp. I don't think it was Lofaso. It might have been Scavone. But yeah, Lofaso did definitely score into Pescara as well. He scored against Fiorentina. He's done it again. Well done, lad. Big, big goal potentially, lads. We all cut the gap to Crotone to 2 points with a win. And we all be hoping Pescara drop points as well. points. Yeah, I mean, we could still be 4 points behind second, but I mean, it's always better than five. Good play. Petrushone. Needed a runner there, really. Get one. Tonali. Benuti. Onto Tonali. Laid it off. Hit that! Oh, it was a good strike from Riccardi. But just wide. We've woken up in the last 10 minutes, guys. I'd take Rattoni edge the first 20, 25 minutes, but we're doing bits now. Unlucky Riccardi.
That's gone out for a throw in.
Still taking nothing for granted. We did lead last game, lost 4-1. We led 2-0 early on the season against Perugia, drew 2-0. We led twice against Pescara, I think. Lost. So we aren't great on leads, but at the moment we do look more like Leeds to score next. Tricardi. To Marino, just going to go for it.
Poor decision. And he connected well enough. Well, he has got a strong shot. We know that, but not his best effort.
Get up. Well in. Trishone. Go on, lad. Allegri. There's just not many runners. No one making the runs, guys. I had one player making a run then. You know, if I pass to him, it's really obvious who I'm fucking passing to.
Very good shielding of the ball.
Well in, Palombi. Tracked all the way back there to tackle Simi. Oh, yes, Palombi. He's there again. All right, touch from Petrushone. Can we break here, lads? Just before half time to Marino.
2 minutes, that's what's going to be played for added time.
You started making the run, Pellegri, then stopped. You dickhead.
To intercept there.
I'd already committed to the pass by then. For fuck's sake. Well done, though, Venuti.
Poor on the ball.
Defending better as the half goes on, for sure, lads. Defended well for the last 20 minutes here. Get there. Get there. Oh, fuck's sake. So, half time. We'll take that all day. It's Crotone 0, Lecce 1. Benevento winning. Of course they are. They always fucking win. I mean, they have been insane this season, to be fair, Benevento. We drew with them. They're still unbeaten. We've only dropped 14 points all year. There's not much we could have done. I didn't see Pescara playing, so we'll play this out and pray that they don't win that game in hand.
Second half.
Trishone. Tonali.
Good work, really, to read the intention of the pass. Cleared it well.
We've got to be winning that. Bobo. I didn't mean that, but I'll take it. Palombi. Good play. Oh, lucky Petrushone. It's going to be a goal kick as well.
Attack has fizzled out here. Goal kick.
Milic.
Making sure there's no turnover.
Oh, unlucky Palombi. We get so unlucky with
and
stuff like this, man.
It's going to be a throw. Alan Smith. You told me this was going to happen. It has happened. Robert
dreadful,
Lewandowski
dreadful ball. They were lucky they had a man there as well.
There's been an awful lot of talk, and why not? It's about 80
oh,
million.
Oh, almost got in there. Unlucky lads. Come on. These are shit. I don't know why Aldi's a second. I mean, as soon as I say this they're playing like gods again.
He's giving it away. It's one
oh god, giving away. Four. Simi. Come on, lads. We need this clean sheet. No, for fuck's sake. Oh. I cursed myself, guys.
So,
they suddenly started passing it around really crisply, but I did hand that to them then, like giving them the chance.
I could have got through there, but the defender.
I'm just never that confident we're going to score quickly as well. It's the only problem. It is hard to score this team. So not particularly good physically.
Now out on the wing.
It's hard to get in behind people. Italian sides are notorious for defending well as well. There's just never many runners for us. Might have a chance here though. Oh, that was high the needle stuff. Nearly did it though. Hit that. Oh, fuck's sake. Play to the keeper. I'm going to stay on attack, and I think 5 points adrift if we keep it. We may go six if Pescara win. It's not irreversible. I think it'd be more dangerous to go all out attack and give them a better chance of counter-attacking and winning.
Trying to keep the ball.
But we probably do need a win here, lads. Come on. So please, at least get another chance and goal. Good play. Worked in. Great ball. Yes, guys! Get in! That's a good goal, boys. Come on. We retake the lead with 20 minutes to go. Can we hold it off this time? It's Pellegrini's first goal for the club. PP Pietro does the business. What a goal that could be come the end of the season, lads. Crotone, who are 5 clear going into this. Four behind at home. Great ball in by Venuti, I think. And he took it well there. Left foot on the volley. Side foot it across the keeper. Pietro Pellegrini has already delivered, guys. We did lose a big player in Fiumozio. I did like plus 500k. But if he continue scoring goals like that, it will be worth it. Is clearly getting ready to come on. Trishone.
Attacking now.
Oh, what a tackle that was.
He wants to clear his lines here, but make sure it's a bit more than just hoofing it upfield.
Oh, these fans know. Benali. No, it's a good ball. No, we're on that. Vigorito. I think he could maybe even left that and picked it up on the edge of the box. I'm not sure Simi would have got there before him. One of the substitutes will be brought into the game.
Home team ready to make a change.
Great ball, Venuti. Tonali. Come on, lads. Can we break here? We might be in. Oh, it's a poor ball from Riccardi.
Saw the pass coming and got there first.
We do have a week gap to Palermo. That's another big game. I don't want to run a risk of an injury here. I'm going to bring Santoro on for what might be his debut. I don't really have options here. Falco, I suppose, should come on. We can go there. Let's bring Garicci on for Venuti, who had a really good game. I think he got the assist. I've always liked Venuti. He's one of the few players I've got, which I think like I can. I always feel like I can do stuff with when I get on the ball. Do those players down on the pitch believe as well here? Trying to pick out someone in the centre. Get rid of it. Hold on, Sandro. It's shown. Who's this man down the bottom, just not making a run? Lazy bastard. Colombi's fucked. Oh, well done. Hit that. Oh, lucky lads. It's Riccardi, I think, with the strike. I'm just going to sit on it now, lads. I'm going ultra defensive. It's late on. I'd be crushed if we concede. What a tackle. Yes, lad. Pellegrini. To Palombi. To Trishone. Well left. Well played, boys. Keeping us nicely. No, oh, wasted in the end. Blow US or air. Yes, boys, big win. Come on. Hyped for that. I'm on my feet. I don't even know why. I stood up. Crotone 1, Lecce 2. We deserved it. Classic FIFA. They scored with the only shot on target. We had 9 shots at their 4, 4 on target to their 1. Edge possession, they edged pass accuracy. They had the only corners of the game. And the match goes to Simone Palombi. He gets an 8.8. We never did make subs. Fuck, no. Alright, Venuti played in 8.1, Lofaso in 8.2, and Pellegrini in 8.4, Tonali in 8.2. So, goals for Pellegrini, Lofaso, assist for Palombi, and that is it, apparently. What was our first goal then? Did we not get credit and assist? It must have been Palombi's ball in for Pellegrini, surely then. I don't remember the first goal we scored. Maybe it was like a rebound or something. I think it was actually, yeah. The keeper saved it, then Lofaso squirmed it in. So, apologies, Palombi. It was actually you who made the assist rather than Venuti. Well played, lads. So let's hope results favoured us. Pescara are yet to play. Palermo lost, I think, get in. In fact, no, they drew. They were a point behind us, weren't they? So they are 3 points behind us now. We play them next. How's our goal difference? It's looking a lot better now. It's 10. The only side with better goal difference than us is Benevento. We got a league top scorers, amazingly. It doesn't seem like we've scored that many. I mean, we scored 4 in one game against Palermo, 5 in another against Pescara. Probably contributed towards that. But as I said, since we went 4-3-3 attack, guys, it took us a while to adjust to it. We're starting to play decent football, and performances of late have been more in line with what I expect and what is necessary, really. Padova have a game in hand. They could cut the gap to 2 points. We're looking a lot more assured for playoffs now. We are 9 clear of Cosenza with that better goal difference as well. Santoro rejected the loan move. Really, bro? Really? We need that money for Fasto, whatever his name is. I can probably go back in from now. I might try. You never know, guys. I mean, the other options we could get in, he'd just be the best of the bunch, I think. Right, where are we? Sorry guys, just sparking my cig again. So there's his weekly wage, 8,300, and he went down to 5,400. We're not really going to be able to get him, I think. He plays for Spal, his valuation's 3.2 mil, it'd be massive to get him in. We'll try. Even if I did manage to get him in, I think like we'd have next to no money left. We don't want to get to the point where we can't promote youth players, because they might leave then. Make him a crucial player, obviously. He would be one of our highest rated. 3 years is fine. No release clause is absolutely fine by me. Same 5 grand. We're only minus 6 in the wage. All right. The additional fees are actually well higher this time. Maybe if we can just remove them. The appearance one, maybe. Say 20 appearances. Would he make 20 appearances this season, actually? I don't think he would. I don't know if that runs for his entire contract. We only have like 15 games left. Maybe it counts some of his games he's played for Spal. I don't know. Edit wage. Euro. Fucking hell. Remove bonus. We still can't afford it. Jesus Christ. I mean, I want to give him his 5 grand. Maybe if we offer him 5, we'll see what this adjusts to. We'd have 12 euros left for that, Jesus Christ. And even then, that wage has gone down. I could afford the wage, but like, basically I'd have to give him nothing extra for signing. And somehow I don't think he's gonna come. We'd have 1,700 left in the transfer budget. That probably would still be enough, actually, to even like, sign more players up, but after 9 months it's gone. We wouldn't be able to send our scouts out again until like the new season when we get our budget. I'll have to just try this, guys. Just try him purely on the wage. He's gonna say no. Now he's upped it. Fuck you, lad. Son of a bitch. Maybe we just try and reduce the wage this time, man. You might take that. 4 grand. Let's go 4,150. It's just half of what he was on. Oh my god, I have to put this down first, don't I? For fuck's sake. It's a struggle, guys. It's a struggle. 18 left on the budget. Could I stretch this to maybe like 15 then? I'll try that. It's pretty much all we can go to. No, he said no. Fuck's sake. Who else could we get then? It's just, I need a bit of money. I cannot believe you don't get money for the cup in this. It's ridiculous. That bit of extra, it's all we needed. Or if we'd have won the preseason tournament or something. We could sign Lavarone, who I think we sold. I mean, physically, this guy's a beast. He's 29, he would start going down in rating. Gary's 25, I don't think we'd be able to get him. It's saying off of the wage between that. It looks the next best, to be fair, Gary. It might be achievable, but we'd pretty much be hoping that he doesn't take any extra in terms of sign-on fees. It said he would consider 4,500, which we might be able to stretch to as long as we give him nothing else. Bianco is a possibility as well, really realistic possibility actually. Maybe it might not matter to get these guys in, boys, next season, that the fact that the 30 odd. It's just that guy for the future would have been a good signing, a good player. Simone Padoin is also an option. The wage, it's saying about 4 grand might do it. He can play left back, left mid, CM. Look at this guy, he's a fucking beast, technically. An early crosser as well. I probably will play him in left wing, actually. Because physically, he isn't that bad for his age. So he's 34. Pizzella is a no. Saputo, I don't even think, is available. I tried to loan Moise Keane as well, by the way, guys. Again, and he said no. Well, actually, no, it said we can't. His contract must be up at the end of the season. Scott Torello is a possibility as well. Physically, this guy is a fucking beast, although he's not strong. For a centre mid CDM, I don't really like that. He has a lot of dreadful stats and a lot of really good stats. It's kind of interesting. Again, it still might be a push though. Pulzetti looks the most realistic one. 34 years old though, 67 overall. He still probably wouldn't even start next year, guys. Because Riccardi's better, Tonali's better, and Scavone's better. I think I'm going to try. Where was he? Schiadone's high work rate from Cosenza. Definitely achievable. Just 30, 69. Bianco, medium, but the high work rate tempts me, man. Look how good he is physically as well, guys. He's pretty damn good. Technically, you can always train that as well. When he's older, I don't know if it'd go up too much, to be fair, but it's going to be the one then, guys. I'm going to go in for Schiadone. Shame about Costa, though. Really is. I wanted him. So, the squad roll. I'm still going to try and get this guy on a cheaper wage, by the way. We're going to go with Important. I don't think he'll start every game, but he will feature most. 2 years, it's fine by me. He is 30, after all. No release clause, spot on. So we'll take a wage cut. The appearance bonus 15. Ooh, we have 15 games left. Again, as I said, I don't know if this counts for the whole. I imagine it's for the whole contract. In 2 years, he wants 15 appearances, then he gets that. So I don't mind that too much, but it will go out of budget now, I think. Signing bonus 12 grand. I'm going to try and counter it. I'm going to try and be cheeky. I think we can get a bit more down on this. Maybe if we take it down to 20, then we take this down, the wage down to 1500, and the signing bonus down to 10. Will he accept that? No, he did take it down a bit. He took his signing bonus down by 1000, his wage down by 100, and his appearance bonus down by 1000. So I do like that. I'm going to try one more. I hope I don't offend him, because I quite like this guy's response. He did take a cut on everything. Just not quite a big enough cut to keep us at least a bit comfortable in our wage. I think that might do us, guys. Yes, he joins. Well in, lad. So he will join in the new season. Schiadone. From Cosenza, one of our rival teams. I think they might be a derby team, actually. Guys, now where does that leave our budget? It's still saying that. Oh, does it just come out when we actually sign him then? Because that changes everything. We could get a few of these players in, guys, and just commit to however amount it is. Good God, I didn't realise this would be the case. I don't know if that took anything out, you know what I mean? Let's try and get another one. I mean, the thing is, guys, not many of these might be starters, but then after a year, we could just sell them and get a bit of money anyway. They are going to be like free signings. Raffaele Bianco is, or Gori was the other one. I mean, maybe should have gone for Gori first, because this guy does look a beast. But that we'd ever be able to get him. Let's try and delegate. Start the wage offer at 3,500. Don't go higher than 3,400. I'm not even sure we could afford that. I don't feel like delegate signing bonuses and shit. That's what he says. Can we afford that? Probably could, actually. Just about. Good God. He's going to say no. It's almost a given. So, on to your training session, guys. We keep these boys on. We're still training Santoro. We rejected the loan offer. So be it, then. Yeah, he just doesn't grow that much, man. Come on, hopefully Pescara lose in a game in hand here. We have another loan offer for Santoro. Is that the same team? I have dealt with these guys. CDO Higgins. Surely in an Irish side. Another one, Brisbane Roar. Accept that one as well. Pescara did win their game in hand, guys. They are four clear of us at the moment. 15 games left. Definitely catchable. Santoro said no. Gori offered him pass. He wasn't willing to accept the offer. He rejected both of them. Fucking hell. Just go away, Santoro. I need that extra 500. It could be crucial. I can't afford to get the other one in, I think, guys. You think I'm stupid? We're going to do it. We just need numbers for next season. Who knows? We could just find a god as well. Somebody plays well beyond the rating. It's going to be Bianco we'll go in for then. Even then, what? His current wage is 2,900. It's saying offering between 4,100 and 5,700. Not a chance. You have to take a wage cut if you want to join the Lecce project, mate. We're going to be Champions League winners one day. It might take a lot longer than I thought it would at the start of this career, based on the squad we have right now, guys. But, yeah, I'll say he's crucial then. To be fair, he probably still would be next year. That might encourage him to take a wage cut. 3-year deal seems sufficient. He wants one, we'll compromise on two then. I should have gone in straight in before then, so maybe I could have gotten on the free. Oh, excellent. Right, he will take it. I mean, we can't actually afford that. We're minus 300. We need to change the appearance and sign and bonus. But the last guy didn't actually take it out of our budget straight off, I think. It's just as long as we can afford it now. Edit wage and sign on bonus. We will, of course, at the end of the season be letting players go back to their parent clubs, like Mercurialio and Palombi anyway. Edit bonus. So this one needs to go down. We'll go 25 appearances, which he almost certainly will make. Try on 15 grand. No, that'll be 5 grand. We do need to edit that wage. Damn, we'll try him on 2 grand. Then this for 10 grand. No, he's still saying this. Fuck you, lad. Just remove the bonus. No, we can afford that. So he takes it. Yes, Bianco. Rafa White. There he is. Medium. And it's another one that we'll sign on a pre-season contract, guys. So do we still have that budget? Oh, okay. It did go down a bit. It doesn't go down by like the signing bonus, I think. It's just a wage, so... Or maybe it's just a signing bonus. I don't know. I need to kind of work out this shit. Our current weekly wages are 42,900. Jesus. Most of that's probably Tonali and Pietro Pellegri, though. But yeah, man, that's some good couple of signings for next year, at least. They are both better than Scavone and Riccardi. Hello, as I said, by that point next year, Riccardi will probably be about 68 anyway. Just bolstered midfield, which is needed right now. We only had Patricioni, Falco, Riccardi, Scavone and Tonali. In terms of best players for the squad, they'll be right up there. Tonali is the best and Lucioni. Thank God Lucioni's not on loan, by the way. Venuti's on loan. No, I didn't realise that. God damn it. At least Falco isn't. But yeah, they'll be right up there. 69-70, about this region. Do we maybe have a... I'm not sure I could afford them now anyway, but... I did check Italian free agents a while ago. And there weren't really any there. Are there any on here now? Maybe they did just get released. Nope. No players found. About on loan. I've managed to loan one player this whole thing. Skamaka is 65 overall. He could be useful. That wage is high though. 6 for 5. Dale looks like he's okay-ish. I'll scout both of these guys. We could just loan him at any time, I think. But it looks like our business is done, guys. Pellegri was the big one. It was a massive signing. And already delivered with that winner against Crotone. Another loan offer for Santoro. It might be the old trick of doing this, guys. What you do is you accept the offer. This seemed to work. I think it's a bug in FIFA. It worked a lot on the other files. Accept the offer, then go squad hub, find him, take him off the loan list, then put him on the transfer list. And there we go. Teams have played extra games, guys. Oh, Crotone, we can leapfrog them. They lost again. Get in. Beaten by Venezia. Go on, Venezia. Who would have thought that a few games ago, guys? A win here today. We'll put 6 points between us and Palermo. Padova didn't win their game in hand as well. We're 5 clear of them. We could put 6 points between us and Palermo, at least 5 between us and Padova, and go a point clear of Crotone. Just hopefully Pescara lose as well. They're playing Salerno today. Salerno are down in 15th, so don't expect them to do too much. Benevento are just way clear at this point. Not even looking at them. But massive game, guys. We beat them 4-1 in Sicily. Palermo last time round. We are going to try and deliver once again. I think the team's fine. I think this is our best team. We need to take Major out from the start, then we... we're putting Palombo on for Scavone. Then we'll just adjust when we go attacking, see how it adjusts.
Describe the action for you. Nice to have you with us. Martin Tyler here and Alan Smith. And the lineup for the home side goes like this. 4-3-3. And they've got natural wide players in that front three with a central striker.
I think that's the key, because those lads on the flanks. It's quite a complicated job actually, because they've got to come inside, support the centre forward, and they've also got a funnel back when they haven't got the ball, so an onus on them.
Palermo will play like this today. So, Alan, 4-4-2?
Yeah, I think it looks that way, Martin. Yes, it's the conventional shape. It's
hold
the
on, boys.
The manager prefers.
Play there, Venuti.
The visitors really have been below par this season.
It's come on, lads. Palombi.
Well, I had them.
Spread it across. Good ball. Oh, strike. It's deflected over. It will be an early corner for Lecce.
Put the corner in the middle.
The ball in. Good idea. Oh, just wide. Great effort. I think it was Mecca Aurelio. Unlucky lad. Let me just check. Everyone is in the right position. Palombi is over on the right. Lofaso on the left. Was that the better thing? He's right foot. He's right foot of 5 weak foot. Yeah, that's fine. Think. We'll check. Mecurelio and Lucioni, are they in the right spots? Yeah. I mean, the only problem is with this side right now, guys. I think this 11 is good enough to maybe get us promoted.
Markovic.
But even a couple of injuries would leave us right in the shit. So we do promote some more youth. We have such a small squad.
With good reason.
Well, he can't stop setting them up. Leading assists with 8.
Decision is a throw. It was a fair tackle. Rajkovic. Now it goes into the wider areas where they've got a winger waiting. Trying to find an opening.
Passing it nicely here. Palermo. Come on, lads.
That's an excellent cross.
Get rid of it. No. Oh, padded wide by Field Delino.
A bit more work, I think.
Yeah, the keeper's waving that one bye-bye.
Good forward play from
a little chip.
Just a mistake.
Really
worked
out. Alassami though. Holding it a long time. Get there. Pass. Well done, Pellegri. I wanted that so much because that guy was taking chances. And he'd get punished for it. Tonali. Chance here, boys. Oh, I just went for the strike like a dick. I should have maybe controlled it and crossed it back in. Well off, Tonali.
Well, they use the forward in these positions, dropping deep. He lays it off and they play from there. A timely challenge. Good work, really, to read the intention of the pass.
Good ball. Falco, good play. We're in. Tonali. Oh, for fuck's sake. New for play. It seems to get in his way somewhat.
Dealt with the problem. Break quickly when they get possession.
So it's such a slow team.
Team and like, attack into.
They just
neatly intercepted.
Speed stats of the opposition doesn't seem to matter in Legendary. They're just always quicker. Little bitches. Might be in here. Go on, Falco. Oh, unlucky lad.
They could have made more of that.
Come on, boys. We're the better team here.
To the clearance then. It's Haas.
Oh, no. Come on, lads.
Oh. He's made the save. He's got to get rid of the ball quickly.
Oh,
picked
shit.
That pass.
Palati.
Now he's got the ball and a chance to create something. Now they're looking to get forward from this position. And find some space here on the flanks. You can see what he was trying to do, but the defender in the way.
Yes, boys. Come on. Palombi. Filthy challenge, that. I'm frustrated at how slow our midfield was pushing up then, though.
Well, that's the least.
You know, the opportunity was there for a counter. In the end, after a while, I only had one option. That was down low. It's dreadful ball. God damn it. Come on, lads. We're getting in good positions, keeping the ball relatively well when we get it, but we haven't really tested that keeper too much. Play Tonali. Nice. Oh, might be in here. Surely, boys. Finish that, Falco. No. Oh, for fuck's sake. It's going to go in. Great turn now. And a strike. Oh, I don't believe that. How lucky can Palermo get? It's blocked by a guy who's already on the deck. Fuck's sake. Just happened to be in a perfect spot. That guy's a should have put that in.
Anticipated the direction
and
of
what is potentially a must-win game. There's a big opportunity to want Began. It's Pellegrini.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this
big
situation.
Big chance here, lads. Lo Faso. Oh, it's blocked by Rispoli, being another corner. Come on, boys.
Corner swung in.
It's a good one. Mechirelio, yes, lads! Come on. The out-wing corners, we have done bits from this season. We do it again. Great corner from Sandro Tonali. And Mechirelio gets there. The guy who is on loan at us this season, and he's been a rock for us this season. Really good player. And deservedly we take the lead, guys, right in the stroke of half time.
Well, it was a beautifully struck corner.
Great ball in. It'll be a third win in a row in Serie A if we can, if we can get this. As we look to get towards Serie A, it would be a massive, massive step, guys. Come on.
To Haas.
I do remember saying, guys, last stream, I looked at, I'll tell you in a minute, I'll break through the stats of the half time first. Firstly, we'll look at all the scores. Pescara only drawing, Benevento actually losing. I don't think we could catch Benevento still, to be honest. We'd be seven behind and they'd have a game in hand, but I think it helped. They are getting beat by Ascoli, who were also lurking around a playoff spot. Cosenza were round there as well, they're winning. But more importantly, guys, the most important score there is Pescara only drawing. We'll cut the gap to 2 points if we hold on here. So the facts, we have 8 shots to their 2, 5 on target to their 1, the edge possession. We had the better of the pass, actually, in the only corners of the game. Definitely deserved that lead. But yeah, I was saying in last stream, last couple of streams actually, I don't really know how the promotion playoffs work in Serie B. Because it might well end up being the route that we have to go by. Because in England and Spain and most other countries, to be fair, it's third to 6th getting the playoffs. It's just 3rd place 6th, 4th place 5th over 2 legs, and the winner's playing the final. It's different in Italy. It works kind of similar to like the IPL in cricket, in that the team that finishes 5th plays 8th in a 1 leg tie at home. You're at home if you're 5th and 6th. You know, 6th plays 7th, 6th will be at home, of course. And the two winners go on to face the sides that finished 3rd and 4th at home. Then the final is the winners of them ties, and it's two-legged. No way. Oh my God, that was such a good ball in. Hard to handle that. So I imagine whichever side finished third then would be at home in the second leg. So, you know, it is important in the playoffs where we finish. Every team up and around it will be decent and capable of beating us, and we'll be capable of beating them. But obviously, third and fourth is the key one. We want to finish at least fourth if we don't finish top two, to ensure that we only have to play two legs to get promoted rather than three.
Another turnover in play.
You know, it would be hard if we finished fifth to eighth to get through three ties, one of them being two leg. It would be really tough. Palermo have been a better team this half, guys. We need to concentrate.
They've got it away from the danger.
It's got great though, potentially. Oh, such a heavy touch in Tonali, but we still get it.
That's a good performance, isn't it, Alan, from him in
Come
the
on,
first
boys.
Half?
Still on this. It's Falco, he's in. Oh, delightful chip. Oh, it's just wide of the post. I did a first touch, and I'd already done my first touch, so then it flicked it ahead. The second touch that he made actually counted as my first, if that makes sense. So it left me basically with the keeper on top of me. I had to go for the chip, but I did think we'd made it. Unlucky. Falco, though, with two glorious opportunities, has wasted them both. And hopefully they aren't punished later on, guys. Palermo have looked dangerous this half. No, give it away softly there. A feint from Haas. And to Rispoli. Rispoli still. That's going to go out. And we'll make subs. So Riccardi's fatigued, he's going to have to come off. Bring on Patricione, Facus Scavone. Bobo can come on for Mechirelio, the match winner as it stands. Bring Santoro on for Palombi. Can he play on the right? Well, he's 5-star weak foot, he can, yes lad. Don't know how good the stats are for there. You can also play centre mid, but we'll just keep him there for now. I almost always concede, guys, so I am worried at just 1-0.
Marco Calderoni. On the move and able to cut out the pass.
Hold on, boys. If I could have just got to that and fed it into Pellegrini, he was in.
And it's kicked upfield by the keeper.
Well done, Benici.
It's gone out for a throw. And 20 minutes to go.
No.
Poor attempt at a pass, really.
I knew as soon as I hit that, it was fucked. Yes, Bobo. That's why you're bringing you on, mate. Fucking beast. Give me options. Fucking move, Benici. God damn it. That could have gone a lot worse. That's all right, ball. Over to Calderoni.
The
feeds
the
Lofaso.
As well as the vision.
Lofaso with a look-back stick. And we win a free kick here in a dangerous position, lads. I don't know whether to shoot here. We do have Bobo on the pitch, who's our best free kick taker in the squad, actually. Here he is. He is decent at them. I mean, it's a tight angle, but if anyone can do it, Bobo can do it.
I have to say, they didn't get away with it, did they? Trying to sneak forward.
Well done, come on, Bobo.
Let's fly!
Can you get on that?
The wall has dealt with it. To get off the ground to do so.
Gonna hit that. You best believe. Sandro Tonali.
He's blocked that well.
Deflection fail. I was going to say favoured us, but we are offside.
Well, I must say,
getting to the point now, guys, where enough's enough. I'm going to go ultra defensive. I'm going to try and just sit on this lead.
He's got eagle eyes.
Well, it looks like Palermo have gone attacking anyway. Yeah, they've committed a lot of men forward.
Move now, as it turns out. What a great call.
To pass. Just working away to try and find an opening. They've worked so hard, the team, to be in front here.
Lads.
And that's been recognised by the supporters.
Yeah, I think they've recognised that it has.
Oh, great play. We're in. Scavone. Pulls one back across. Fuck's sake.
Out of a pretty deep hole then. It was a great chance, I thought. But
I'll be kicking
again.
Myself if we don't win this game, guys. We've got so many chances. That's a right ball. No, Calderoni might not have the pace. Thank God that was a dreadful ball in by them. Oh, dreadful clearance from Benici, though.
As they build
no,
attack.
It's Folletti.
Going forward well.
Yes, boys.
Dangerous looking attack.
I'll get rid of it. I'm not learning my lesson here. I'm just fanning about.
Throw in coming up. Now a chance to get a bit of width into this attack.
Oh, unlucky.
Should really deliver from this position. But the defender in the way.
Shit.
Oh, ref says play up.
Well, that was a bit lax.
From the referee.
No, Cesare Bobo.
That was a yellow card.
I don't know. You know, Martin, I know another referee might not book him for that offence.
Oh, that's good defending. Can go in from here.
No, no, oh my fucking God, man. I'm so upset, lads. Last minute, they've had one shot on goal, I think. For fuck's sake. Why does it always happen, this difficulty? It's shit like that, which is why we're not going to get promoted, I think. Certainly not automatically. Why? Why did we lose this game? I had so many chances to win it. For fuck's sake. They didn't deserve it. We're so unlucky, man. Every time I drop points to teams, they do fuck all. We had 11 shots at 5, 7 targets at 3. Dominated the game. They had a better possession and pass accuracy. We had the only corners of the game. Can't believe it. 91st minute, man. I don't even think they had 3 on targets. I don't remember them at all. Fuck's sake, lads. The goal from Mecchi Aurelio, by the way. The assist was Falco, actually. He took that corner. I'm annoyed at that. Pescara might be 6 clear now. They only drew. We missed a chance. Padova lost, thankfully. So, what's damage limitation? But Crotone haven't played yet. We missed a chance to leapfrog them. In fact, that was our game in hand, yeah. It could have been worse. We're still 4 behind Pescara. Point behind Crotone. for Benevento and Musa Giroud as well. We're still 10 behind them. They have a game in hand. Yeah, they are just gone. 3 clear of Palermo, 4 clear of Perugia now. We're up there in 6th. They beat Padova to leapfrog them. But that was a heartbreaker. There's been so many like that against sides around us as well. It's a shame. We battered Crotone, drew with them 2-0. We backed Pescara, lost 3-2. You know, we're 2-0 up against Perugia. They drew with us 2-0. Just lax, man, lax. The only side up and around there that deserved to take points off us were Benevento, and we drew with them. It was an even game, a really good game. Probably was the best opposition performance against us. That's how I actually, Spezia played really well against us, and we got them next, I think. I'm so frustrated with that one, man. It was a heartbreaker. The Santoro finally got loaned out. Oh yeah, because I did the trick. Yeah, that's why, guys. I mean, just go, like, loan them, get an offer, then transfer list them, then it panics them into going, I think. He's gone to Sweden. Sarpsborg, 08. I think they're Swedish. On a scout report on this guy, who I think was loan listed. No point really getting him, guys. He's kind of quick. His finishing's only 59, though. His dribbling's okay. Yeah, I don't think there is a point in getting him in. Like, we have an offer. Not a chance in hell am I selling Giuseppe Marino, who's our best youngster right now. I mean, I suppose Mancini is, but he's not available just yet, guys. He needs to get available soon. Every time you get a squad feature star in, they never seem to be available till about May. I don't know if that's just a preset that you can't have them for the start of the season, or I just get unlucky on the birth dates. Did I get another offer? I have another message here. I just ignored. Interest sharing in Maggiore. Can't get anyone else in. We have barely any money as it is. Dele Alli to United for almost 100 mil. Wow. Palace just signed Poulsen. That's a good sign, isn't that? Another offer for Marino. No, I am not selling him. Fuck off. So another month, guys, to check our youth. The Rossi potential didn't really favour us. He's probably going to be a showing great prospect, though, to be fair, which isn't too bad. Mancini could still be really good. Giordano is a no, sadly, guys. We're going to release him. Alessandro Costa, Luca, still 15. Oh, damn it. Rizzo just gone up in rating. 77 to 91 still. It might be worth starting to train this guy. We do have our boss left back in Marino, though. Oh my god, right, I mean, sack Rizzo, because Michele Mancini looks like he's going to be a god. Russo is definite no then. As is Ferrari. We did have speed though. Might keep hold of him for now. Gabriele Mancini is still looking good. Casade is probably going to be a no. I'll give him one more month though. In fact, no, he's been there a while. Yeah, fuck this guy. So, squad hub, guys, start of a new month, see if anyone grew. I think Ricci did, nice. Alright, Riccardi. Don't think he grew, actually. That other Riccardi did, yes, lad. Pellegrini's grew already. Going up to 69 now. Has that changed now? No, still saying showing great potential. I don't understand this. Paid like pretty much his valuation, the 500k plus Fiamatti. It was shame about Fiamatti. I did like the guy, but yeah, we started using him as like a filler, essentially. Right, next game, guys, is against Cremona. We have a week gap from Charlie's games. A lot more of the fixtures now this season are spread out, to be fair. They're pretty much throughout, nice. Whereas, obviously... I mean, they've kind of been spread out all season, to be fair. It shows the power of, like, barely any cup games. So, I can't really blame that. We've got a couple there in a row. Just keep gotta keep chucking, guys. 14 games left. We gotta put the disappointment last game behind us. I mean, this is gonna be the last game of the stream. Probably gonna get off, get something to eat, then pop back on in a bit. Come on, boys, let's do it. We have played pretty well so far in the stream, I think. Got a win, draw, and a defeat for our efforts. Does rather sum it up.
So we think it's going to be 3-5-2, Alan, don't we?
But if we keep going in that way, we should be capable of getting two, maybe three wins on a bounce, which puts us in really good stead.
This is the lineup for the away side.
It's good for us, so the opposition have been kind of inconsistent, with the exception of Benevento, really. They've not had that good seasons.
It
shows how competitive this league is, really, guys. Anyone can take points off anyone. Yes. Falco. Tonali. Oh, Falco was through as well. He didn't quite cut the play there. That was a right ball by Cremona. Good touch by Calderon. If we could do need to change positions again, yeah, I remember now. Oh, we didn't take Scavone off. That's what we're supposed to do. We need to take Major off the subs, the start as well. Palombi on. Alright, we'll leave Scavone there for now. Is he any quick? He's kind of fast. Yeah, he had a bit of pace about him. He's left footed though. High medium work rate, to be fair, on the wing. Fuck it. I think
throw.
He might be able to do a job.
Bit of space for him. Now out on
Yeah, I need to remember to stop Palombi from this off though. We need three forwards up there. Oh my god! Off the ball! What the fuck? I don't think that guy meant that. I think he was going for the cross. Vigorito and myself concerned for a split second. Benuti. Oh, he's held it way too long, man. We could be in trouble here. We're playing quite sloppy football early on in this one.
Trying to find a way through here. Probing away. Well, that's straightforward for the goalkeeper.
On to Cavani.
The wide man can show his skills here.
Good football, boys. Where's the support though? Fuck off. Just nowhere, non-existent.
Couldn't hold on to the ball. Well, this could be dangerous in a wide position. Bit of keep ball going on here.
Shots. Hit that. Oh, off the post! Unlucky boys, that was a good move. We were patient. Just pick the opening, give us a Falco. Filippo Falco, who couldn't score one-on-ones before, and he's got a great goal then.
Well, he's got the ball there in the defensive zone by reading the play very well. It's good vision to be able to switch the play there. Player's done well here until it was the direction of the pass, really. Right idea, but couldn't find his man. It's out over the touchline.
Nice play, boys.
Marco Calderoni.
Oh, on again. Green. Why did I take the torch?
To
I didn't even actually make him do it, but you know what I mean is why did Tonali take the touch? I just held it. Oh, it's a great ball though. We should be in. Oh my God. Take it with your left foot, Gavone, please. Oh, in front of finesse. We should be winning this game, lads. It's a good goal now.
Swung in from the corner. Only partially clear. The shot's on.
Oh, the deflection favoured them. Obviously it did. That's a great ball.
Could get the ball into
Calderoni. Oh, it's a challenge.
Good screening, and he's kept the ball.
Done low Faso.
Marco Calderoni.
We do look like scoring. It's the positive to take from this start, guys. Good ball, again. Lo Faso. Great ball in. Back stick to Scavone. We'll get another opportunity. Scavone. Oh, no way. Pellegri took it off him, I think, when it would have been better leaving it for Scavone. Oh, that's a nice dummy.
Longo. Going forward well. Safety first there.
Good play. Riccardi.
This turnover could be costly against a side that can break like this.
Oh,
probing.
My God. Stem balls where you have to kind of slip it through two of them. I never seem to get them off. It's just a straight through ball. Even with Tonali. Well done, Mercurialio. It's Shen. Lo Faso.
He's got some room out here in the wide position. They've got the ball back. The interceptor got it for them.
Come on, boys. The panicking.
He's got it away.
We are pinning them back quite well. Tonali, hit it. Ah, raised over. I did take a deflection now. I didn't realise that. VA corner. Still corner. Should be. Oh my God, how did we not win the header? With so many players in prime position for it. Riccardi, good play. Hit that. Sandro Tonali. Why do you always take touches? Oh no, he stayed down. There's not a player we want to get injured, lads, for.
2 minutes. Marco Calderoni. Longo.
So, 0-0 off time, lads, but we have been easily the better side. I'm getting tired of saying it now. So we should be winning these games. Palermo winning. Salerno beating Crotone, nice. Perugia are also winning. We've got to be wary of Perugia if we keep dropping points. They are catching up to us. I'm going to keep the side as it is for now, but we'll bring Palombi on quite early. I've never actually looked at the facts. It does look like Tonali shrugged off his injury, nice. Yeah, I don't even have a shot. We tied possession. We edged past actually at the only corners of the game. We had 5 shots and 2 on target.
Here we go with the second half.
There were big opportunities though as well. Like, kind of glaring misses. Might be in here though. Hit that. Fuck's sake. I thought I had to take it straight off. I'm not sure I could have taken the touch and looked inside a bit more. I played fast. So, good corner. They've put some really good corners in actually, but they keep getting clear.
That's
a dreadful ball by Tonali. Cremona cannot get out their own half right now though, lads. They literally have every man in their own half. No, no, he read that long ago. Fuck.
This, if they're going to make progress, giving it straight away. Well, he's pressed him there to running the ball out of play. Well, getting the right kind of player is always a problem, even for a side like Manchester United. They do believe in this transfer. They have got the right kind of player.
Yeah, and I think that's a really good sign. And the fans are excited. Maybe excited by the.
Oh my God, that was just an absolutely woeful pass. By Riccardi, I think.
On the
across
move,
Scavone.
Able to cut out the pass. Substitution that the home side want to make. Short passes, but they're keeping the ball.
Riccardi.
Shots on here.
Oh, I'm just crowded out.
Not really in trouble.
They're just sitting back. Sitting deep. What's the point, Cremona? Come at me, bros. Fucking fannies me. And play. On Falco.
Attacking well here.
Hit it. Why'd you let it run across? Yeah, these are pissing me off now. Are we not winning this game, lads? Come on. What ball? I just can't get through. It's just this wall.
That will help ease the pressure.
Oh, look how many men they've got back. Nine. Fuck's sake. It's the painful thing about legendary. You need players that have good vision and like agility and balance, and Miles don't really have it because they just sit deep as fuck, the computer. Then once a half they'll keep the ball really well, get an attack and almost always test your keeper or score. And this is going to be the attack, I can tell. Look, all of a sudden that was nothing, it's just turned it on. Get in now, Scavone. And actually we might be in now, yeah, lads. It's Pellegrini
taking on the defenders.
Go on, Pellegrini. Oh my god, the shot was shit. I don't know how foot he is, he might be left footed. He is right footed, that was just embarrassing. So Scavone is going to drop back, Riccardi will pop there and we'll bring Palombi on, we need him. Trishione comes on for Tonali. And who else? Marino will come on for Lefaso. And again we'll put Calderoni on the wing. I'm going to go ultra attack, guys, we need to win this.
Yeah, he really did get the laces behind it.
You know, run out of teams there and around us that we actually have to play, where we know we can directly influence their results. I don't want to have it out of our own hands.
Never looked like reaching its target, and they're away with the ball. This could lead to a chance. It's good attacking play.
No.
Longo. It's a poor touch, and the possession's gone away.
So well there, Riccardi. No, Filippo's held on that way too long. We'll get it back though. Keep it in.
They spread it out wide here. Chance to get some width into this attack.
Oh, offside.
Ooh, it's close, Alan. Offside is given.
You can't break these down right now, guys. They're so defensive. They're all just sat right back.
Plenty of warming up going on, and now I think one of the substitutes will be brought into the game.
I could have took my chance on a first off.
As they build this
really.
Attack. Trying to lift it over the nearest defender and he couldn't.
Good header.
It's looking good.
Can't see it, boys. He's an acres. Falco! It just wasn't good, was it?
We've got 10 minutes left on the clock.
Oh, shrugged it off there. Got a bit lucky there. I've had a few of them this game, to be fair, but I just can't fucking score. And that is not a foul. It's just unlucky. The guy stood there. What else can I do? The guy just ran into me. Keep picking these headers up though, lads. Nice.
What a game we've got here. The score's still level.
Falco could maybe be in. Oh, he's so weak.
That didn't lead to more.
Come on, boys.
Saw the pass interception. And got there first.
Ah, come on.
The ball.
What a fucking shit pass that is, you shit cunts. You wankers. I actually hate them, my team. They're fucking shit.
Now the goalkeeper can.
What a heavy touch that is as well. How bad are you guys, man? Come on.
What an excellent
put inside.
Come
well.
They could still win it.
I'm not saying. Oh, there's so many men in the way. Cremona, you are depressingly dull. Well, you don't sit back all fucking game. I didn't get away with that. I can't believe we drew that, guys. We battered them. We're the only team that tried to do anything. They just turned up, parked the bus, and we sat there. Look at them. 9 shots to their none, 5 on target to their none. We've dominated the ball as well, 54% possession. They were playing like a 6-4-1 then. Swear down. Oh, we had the only corners of the game. Better pass accuracy. We dominated every stat except the one that mattered. They made 9 tackles. We only made 2. We only really needed to make 2. They were kind of shit going forward. But 9 tackles, they just flung bodies in the way, got crucial blocks. We missed a couple of chances which we should have put in. We also hit the post. My Falco. It's unlucky, lads. Falco got man the match, 7.8. Their keeper got a 7. Played pretty well. But we just continue to drop points in the league, guys. Palermo and Perugia both won, because only drew. They have a game in hand on us, the free clear of us. As for the rest, it's just going down a point each time. Crotone, one clear of us, Palermo, one below us, and Perugia, one below them. Do we have another game before the next batch of players? Yeah, we do. Against La Spezia, who beat us last time. They beat us 2-0. So look for revenge against them, motherfuckers. It's two draws in a row against Cremona. We've loaned Santoro out, guys, so we can't train him now. Let's get Pellegri on the train, of course. We need him good. I should have been doing this already, really. Could train him on this, for sure. The Kev's only 27. He could grow quickly. Train him on this. Not by getting D's. God damn it. Might take Mancini off two training sessions. He's not even eligible to play right now, so I think it's time to train some of the other first teamers. So Pescara did win. Fuck. Crotone have played their game. We have a game in hand on them, and we're a point behind them. So, got to win, really, guys. Pescara are starting to get away with us. Way from us, sorry. 13 games left, 89 points available. We need to do something. Player returns from injury though. Oh, Petinari's back. Yes, boys. What a time to return. Oh, that was the guy on the loan list. The guy, he could be useful actually. The wage is a bit heavy. Yeah, I don't think I could afford him. I'll leave it for now. Because we do have Petinari back now. Or certainly very soon. And he's changed the team from the base anyway, guys. Major was on the bench. And he isn't even eligible to play. So, return Petinari to the bench for now. I'll also make the change of Palombi goes there. Then he swaps for Lofaso. I think it will auto swap once we start the game. And go attacking. We almost always play attacking from the off, of course. So, come on, boys. I did say that last one would be my last game in this thing, but nah, I quite feel him playing on. Wave of Hunger's kind of passed. This looks like another training session as well. I'm not onto this shit.
Welcome to you all. I'm Martin Tyler, Alan Smith is with me. As always, we'll try not to make any slips in the commentary, but there might be some slips out on the pitch, Alan, in these wet conditions.
Yeah, and I don't think it's going to stop during the course of the match, so I don't think it's going to affect the game in any way in terms of calling it off, but it might get very wet for the players.
This is the home team lineup.
Tonali.
He's got his shot off now.
Hit that.
The shot
gets blocked. Still got away with it, fucking hell. We just kept getting the ball back then. Kind of stuff that happens for the opposition, but every time with the block, the Spezia dealt with that well.
There's a chance for a double for the team that are the visiting team today.
The ball.
Had a good win against this
nice takedown as well from Falco.
In the
other
match,
it's a spread one across.
Earlier in the season, but I'm sure the hosts are really determined to get some revenge.
Yeah, I'm sure they are. They should be, because they didn't play well in that earlier game, but great chance here for the visitors to take 6 points off their opponents.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here.
Good ball. Come on, lads. Riccardi. Oh, we have plenty forward there. This is more like it.
Got the opposition back, steered through. Played in the clear.
Yes, boys. We walked into the net. That is more like it. Get men who will commit to going forward. I need that many people up there for counter attacks and to move the ball that quick to score in this difficulty, really, with players that aren't quick enough to get in behind that often. That was a really good counter attack. Lightning from the boys. Great ball across there by Sandro Tonali into I think it's Falco who just puts it on a plate for Pietro Pellegrini. Gets the second goal for the club, and we do take a crucial lead here, guys. Lecce 1, La Spezia 0.
So the first goal, it's 1-0. trying a bit too hard, trying to force the pass, and it went straight to an opponent. Mora, short passes, but they're keeping the ball. It's a deep cross towards
no.
the back post.
Oh, great block, Lucioni. Well in. I have a habit of trying to clear it by pressing X to lead an attack, but every now and again it just passed straight to them. I got put on my arse then, badly. Oh my god. That was a free header, to be honest. Straight to the keeper, a really weak header as well from LetsPlay. We escaped.
The keeper had other ideas.
There. Falco. Great play this, lads. We're in. Palombi. Oh, it's a post. Should have finished that. Palombi,
well,
come on.
Dig themselves out of a pretty deep hole.
Mufaso. Falco.
Chance, I thought, but they're safe again. Mora.
Come on, lads. We've got these on the ropes somewhat. It's time to compile the lead. I would have managed to get that pass if their defender had been on me a split second later, even.
I
think
the wide man's got a chance here. There's
and it would have been 1-1. Oh god damn it.
Got past his
turned
here.
Way too easily.
Clip it into the middle, but the defender getting in the way.
Lumpelagri. It's a good puff all that.
Good position.
Riccardi takes a touch.
Well.
A sign for the strike. It's just dreadful.
Now.
Jesus Christ.
In the raffle,
but sometimes forget how short. Bad the players are, then we'll lose something though. Like that, and I remember. Jesus. No! Oh my god! Almost on that, lads. Unlucky. We're causing all sorts of problems here, though. Might be an again good touch by Ligi. Palombi to take the throw in, or is it to Tonali? Nice turn from Riccardi. Falco.
He's got support.
Tonali. Great ball in. Surely. Oh, it was a good header as well. We did get power in it, but straight to the keeper. That was a really nice move though, lads. We are playing well. That's why I carried on. I want to carry on the stream while I feel like. In terms of the actual match and performances, we're doing well.
This is the kind of
even the game, the one game we won, we should have won by more against Crotone. But aside from that, every other game we have been a better team. I need to stop doing stuff like that though.
Well,
Jesus Christ.
Creating chances, I'm sure they'll take one. That was a decent effort, you know.
I stand by what I said last stream as well, guys. If we had managed to loan Moise Keane in, if he'd accepted it, we'd have been top by a distance, I think. He'd have scored so many goals for us. Because we do create chances. We just don't really put them away. It'll take us like 5-6 on target to get a goal on average. Oh, that's a right ball. Might be in again. Surely it's time. Yes, boys. We do make it 2-0. And it is so deserved. It's Pellegrini again on a hat-trick now. He's only scored one goal for us in about 4 games beforehand. And he is ticking now, though. Number 21. I'll keep him that, I think. He get auto signed him, but I don't mind that. Play a little ball inside. I think it's Falco again.
Like
the second
one.
Assist of the game.
Pellegrini
has put LetsPlay to the sword here, surely. Game over now.
Can really get at the opposition here.
Oh, this guy, though. He's just done me. Well then, Mecurelio.
And the decision is a corner here.
This crowd's been starved of excitement, starved of action.
Get red.
Get a little bit here.
Have we been starved of action? It's 2-0, Alan Smith. You dick.
Two added minutes.
Fucking moron.
Read that well with the interception.
That was good play. Kind of have to go back. Pellegrini. He's done really well.
Referee! Are you actually fucking high, man? I'm through. I don't believe that. I'm actually flabbergasted by it, for fuck's sake. Cheeky bastard, man. I'm in then. And the fair does completely wrap it up. Oh, man. Elsewhere, at least Palermo are getting beat, guys. At home by Salerno.
Benevento are drawing with Perugia again. I'll probably rule Benevento out of being caught, particularly after 1.06 the last two games. If we won both of them, actually, I would have said maybe we can catch Benevento. But I'm looking at that more the fact that Perugia are only drawing. Match facts, we had 8 shots at 3, 6 and 32, dominated the ball again. Pass accuracy was good once again. We have done well with that this stream so far. They're the only corners of the game. What I haven't done so well in this game is just passing straight to the opposition. We did it twice.
Well, we're going
to
get some thrills in the
maybe even three times.
Spills, that's for sure,
as long as we're doing something stupid like that, we should be good. Because if they do score, I will be flapping, guys. I will be nervous. Because it is a trademark of our season, really, that we're outplaying opponents. Having all the territory, all the ball, most of the chances. And somehow, I've only probably won about half of those games where we've absolutely dicked opponents. Normally if we don't play so well and we just don't get the win, we don't do it in reverse, we get undeserved wins. Oh.
Richie. Mora.
Should have done so much more with that attack then. It was really lax.
Richie.
Well done, Calderoni.
Well, this is where managers really earn their money. In a losing situation, they've got to make a substitution. Got to get it right, really, to have any chance of getting anything from the match. Little private game between the two of them. Shot on! He blocked that well. He has cleared it well. Richie.
Come on, lads. Stop there, start with a ball that is. Oh, it's a good goal. Fuck's sake. I didn't even think that guy would be a threat then. He picked a one pass out. That was unbelievable and a great finish. Matteo Ricci. I'm sure we have a Matteo Ricci. Is that our player, actually? Did we loan him out? Because I'd be absolutely fuming if it is. I might have to check up. We have a Richie. I'm pretty sure he's still having the squad. Oh, might be in here though, boys. For the lead again, and we get it. Get in, boys. Sandro Tonali puts it in. Gets us a 2-goal lead straight away to calm the nerves. Great response, boys. That was the response of a team that does smell promotion. I'm up for it.
So a real captain's contribution here.
Great turn and pass by Pellegrini. He's had a right game of it. 2 goals and assists for the lad now. A fair goal in Serie B for Sandro Tonali. We're going to make subs next time round. I literally just remembered as they kicked off. But that was big for his nice turn. What a tackle, Mecca Riello. Yes, lad. I fucking love Mecca. Like, we might have to sign him on a permanent next year. He'll go back to his loan club. We'll find him. Maybe look at getting him in. Bring on Bovo, put Riccardi there. Bring on Scavone for Tonali, and also, oh yeah, there's our Ricci. We still have him. Let's put him on. He didn't play a lot. We'll put him on the wing, see what he can do. Or Palombi. Yeah, I think he's only played one game this season, our version of Ricci. So let's try and
Cesare Bovo.
Give him a run out while we're touch more comfortable than we have been a lot of times this season. So I always feel like we can get in behind this team.
They've got it away from the danger.
Great defensively.
He's cutting
plus
out.
They're not sitting back like Cremona, little fannies.
It's safe to play it back to the goalkeeper. He's good with his feet.
No, oh, no.
Hitting hard and low. I must say,
what the fuck?
Took a chance and got away with
I
it.
I clicked pass and he passed there. The actual. Oh, God. We need to be careful here, boys. I could easily play myself into trouble here. Alright, we have played it out. Nice.
There's going to be a substitution. It's for the away team.
Calderoni. Wait for the run of Lofaso. He's never fucking made it. Just stood there like a blaze.
Plenty of width for the team to attack into, and they get it away.
Time ticking on.
It's their midfield, their problem, the Spaziers.
15 minutes to go.
We're countering a lot here. Oh, should have got to that. Great tackle. Still alive. Ball is on here. Can we squeeze that in? Oh, good save from Lamanina. I think that was Ricci actually took that strike. Can be Balbo, the centre back, to take this.
And in it goes. Well, that's good.
It's all to Riccardi. The wrong player, really. Hit that.
Hit it well.
Hit that.
Here's the shot.
Oh, I thought that was going in then, boys. Scavone with an outrageous effort on the half volley. But Kaelin, there's a bit Benjamin Favard about that. Just didn't quite care enough. Unlucky, boys.
Now the countdown is to 10 minutes left.
Nice ball. Pellegri. Just held on to it way too long. Well in, Scavone. We've played well again, boys. I'm quite proud of our midfield's performance here. We've completely overrun theirs. During the time you're wasting, Le Spazio, I mean, you keep passing about here if you want. I'm happy for that.
Here's a chance to just stretch the opposition with a bit of width.
This is unreal, actually, how many passes it is. If it does go in, it's a sick goal.
Plenty of space out wide, and they're
going to get it. Boys. All half and nothing. Hey, Le Spazio, fuck yous. It was a shit pass by me, given away. Creamy onto Bidai.
Still got a bit to do, but this is promising.
Hit red.
Put away, but
well done, Lucio. Ricci. Go on, Ricci. Yes, lad. The youngster, he's still going.
Now, this is an interesting
gonna
attack.
Hit it. Ricci. There's full time, though, guys. Big win for us. Back to win aways after two in the league final victory. We have absolutely dominated this game. We thoroughly deserved it. We had 13 shots to their 7, 8 in target to their 3, 52% off the ball. They had more corners and edged the pass actually. Man of match goes to Pellegri. We had a number of candidates here though. We got 9.6, but Falco got 9.5, Tonali got 9, Riccardi an 8.1. So goals for yes, Palermo lost. Benevento and Perugia drew. Good results for us, guys. Pescara is still the key. We're three behind them. They have a game in hand. But we're up to third. Above Crotone as well. So, lovely stuff, guys. It is all quite tight right now. Between, like, second and sixth. Maybe even seventh. I'll have to look down at the table. I don't know. Oh, Mancini Groves, still got him on two sessions. I did say I was going to put him in one. I must try and remember that next time. Look at his sprint speed, guys. Nearly 74. He's 16. Oh, well, 15. Oh, yes. More good news. We have a batch of players. I always get excited when it's the 11th of the month because of this. Davide Santoro is going to be a no. Same with Esposito. And Gasparoni. Fucking hell. Fabio Casadei could be good. There's 3 months in as well. Gonna sign him up for sure. Stefano Giordano, we just had one of them. He was a keeper. He wasn't any good. This guy we're gonna sit on. Russo, yeah, he's a no. Look at this guy, Lorenzo Giordano. Could he be the god? Two of his best stats on out yet as well. Moretti could be good. Daniele Rizzo could be good. Oh, three of his best stats. Sign him up. And Giordano, 52 to 68. Come on, please be at least 60. He did 17 and we could promote him. Moretti looked good as well. That a lot of them have signed up just a month in, so it could turn out they're not that good. But it looked kind of promising that month. Giordano's a forward as well. Where is he? I know he's a centre mid. Oh, it's 50 overall, for fuck's sake. Francesco Giordano. Maybe that was the one we brought in. Yeah, he's 56 overall. Bit of pace about him. Charlie Mancini, still 15. Luca Mancini's still 15 as well. This guy's so good, man. This guy is 48. He's only 15. Centre back. Physically, he's not too bad, though. But, I mean, strength 42 is a concern, though. Why is this Kevin free kick actually so good and he's a centre back? I don't understand this shit. FIFA does it all the time. He just gives weird stats, breakdowns to people. Michele Mancini's 16. Yeah, he's just turned 16. Getting boys. We'll promote him and start the spam of training because he is potentially 86 or 92. Get in the squad, lad. None of the others really look like candidates, I think, right now, guys. So, good and bad that month. The ones that they bring through didn't look quite as good, but the potentials are still up there. We'll see what it revises to. It's just the overalls are really bad. Sometimes they're just too bad and it'll take way too long to train. You know, barely any of them will get game time. At the end of the day, if we do get promoted this year, straight away we're at the highest level in Serie A. So, how much game time are these guys going to get in Serie A? Once I start signing actual Italians that are already in the game. I can't remember what I was going to do then, guys. Oh yeah, I'm going to check this guy I promoted. He was a left back, I think. Mancini, here he is. He can also play centre back. Okay, that could be big. If he has the stats for it. Medium high, 2-star, 2-star. So the weak foot's not great. We'd have to play him on the right. Strength's decent. He's not particularly... Wow, sprint speed 70. His acceleration's bad, but physically he is quite good for 16. Stamina 70. I think I will turn him into a centre back. His slide tackle and stand tackle are only 56 and 60. I can train that. His head and accuracy 55. That can be trained as well. His marking's just 50. Yeah, he... Medium high. I think he is more of a centre back. So ignore the left back. I will play him at centre back from now on. I'm going to start training this guy to 60, guys, and it looks like he's going to be an exciting prospect centre back. Big news there. Pescara lost their game in hand, boys. Get in. They are still just free clear of us. We still have the better goal difference on them as well. Hello, it's quite close now, actually. Their goal difference is 10, ours is 12. They got beat by Verona 2-1, but the last fixture before that, they must have smashed someone. Oh, they beat Benevento. Oh, Benevento's winning run finally came to an end. I didn't even notice that. I tell you what, we're only 7 behind Benevento now. They have a game in hand. But maybe, guys, they are starting to drop points. I mean, they've drew 2, lost 1 of their last 4, Benevento. And if we hadn't dropped the 5 points against Palermo and... whatever other shit on team that was. It was 4 points. We drew 2 in a row, didn't we? Yeah, we dropped 4 points against Palermo and Cremona. We'd have been right up there then. We'd have been second. But, I mean, I'll take it, guys. Ascoli win their game in hand. They're going to be just 5 points adrift of us into seventh. So we have got to look over our shoulder as well. But our goal difference is better than all of them. Except Benevento, so... happy days. I will be here for this stream though, guys. I'm not going to play another one, I think. I'll get off, have a bit of a break. Might come back on tonight. But I'm getting a bit tired, I might not. Who knows? The next time I stream may well be tomorrow afternoon. After work. Yeah, Venezia away, Benevento at home. Oh, Salerno away. And Ascoli home, then there'll be another batch of players. So only 4 games this time for our next batch of players rather than 5. That is the most excited I get every month, basically, on the 11th. Some gods in. But anyway, guys, until that time arises, I'll see you very soon, hopefully, for that next stream.